In this unit, we'll see some more sophisticated sed commands, as well as various examples of how we can utilize sed in practice. I often use sed in order to automate the renaming of many files. When I have tens or hundreds of files that I want to rename in one batch, I write a small sed one-liner that will do that. Here is an example.
Suppose we have a list of HTML files. Each file consists of a base name, followed by a dash and a language code, and ends with .html. Our goal here is to move the files corresponding to each language into separate directories, keeping only their base names. We observe that there are three languages: English, German, D for Deutsch, and French. First, I create a directory for each one of them. Now, I want all English files to move into the English directory, the German files into the German one, and the French files into the French directory. I also want to remove the now unneeded language suffix from the names. How can we do that? We can create a sequence of rename move commands. I first list the files and then pass them to sed using its substitute s command. The pattern I want to match starts with / open bracket to store the following sequence: anything but a dash any number of times because of the star. I denote the end of the sequence I want to store with / close bracket. Then I continue with another sequence to store, again within a set of / open and close brackets. This sequence consists of two characters which represent the language code. As expected, the pattern ends with / dot to denote a literal dot and HTML. Next comes the pattern I want to substitute it with. This starts with mv, the rename command, continues with space /1 to obtain the file's base name, dash /2, which is a language code, and ends with .html. This is the original file name, which I renamed to the following: /2, //, which is the language code, but as a directory name this time, followed by /1, again the base name, followed by the .html suffix, followed by /p in order to print the result. Now, running this command, we get as output the sequence of mv commands. According to the first command, the file contact.de.html is moved into de/contact.html, and similar for the other commands and files. However, this output only prints the mv commands. It doesn't actually execute them. In order to execute them, I repeat the command sequence and pipe the output to sh, which is a Unix shell. We've used the shell up to now to run our commands and scripts. Here, I use it to run all the mv commands. Now, listing the current directory, we get the three subdirectories, de, en, and fr. To verify that the files have also been renamed, let's list one of the directories. I choose the English one, and we can see that it indeed contains contact.html, FAQ, index, news, and products without the language code suffix.
Sed provides a feature called the hold space. The hold space is like a variable. You can use it to store data from one processed line and use it later on. Let's see an example.
Consider this LaTeX document. It contains markup specifying some sections, and for each section there is a comment regarding who will work on it. Let's suppose I want to move each comment on the same line with the corresponding section. How can we do that? Again, we can use a sed script. I run sed-e to specify the commands I want to execute directly in line with the sed invocation. This is an alternative to the script we used in the previous example. Then, when I find the section pattern, I copy with the lowercase h command the pattern space, which is the entire line with the section, into the so-called hold space. Think of it as a calculator's memory. In this way, I can later use it. I also delete the pattern space and start a new read cycle with the d command. Then, when I find a to-do comment, I append with a capital H command the pattern space, which now contains the comment, to the hold space. As you may guess, this process joins the section title with a comment. Now, with the lowercase g command, I copy back the whole space to the pattern space in order to replace the single comment with a joined string. Finally, I remove the new line that was embedded between the section title and the comment so that the two appear on the same line. Running this command on chapter.tech, we get the expected result, the markup of the section titles joined with the comments on who will work on each section.
Sed supports conditional statements. Here is an example that converts a series of assignment statements into a tuple assignment.
To see an example, consider the file named ntuples.txt, which contains various variable assignments. I want to convert these separate assignments into ntuple assignments. In other words, I want a, b, c in brackets to equal 3, 5, 8 in another bracket pair, and k, j to equal 8, 9 again in brackets. Let's write a sed script for this purpose in a here document. I start by creating at the beginning of the line two empty ntuples using two sets of open and closed brackets. Next comes the loop label, denoted with a colon, which is the location where I will loop each time I succeed with a substitution. Let's now see the substitution command. I first match an open bracket, followed by anything but a closed bracket, and ending with a closed bracket. This is the first ntuple. At the beginning it's empty, but it gradually grows. Then I specify a second ntuple. Again, I match an open bracket, followed by anything except for a closed bracket, and then a closed bracket. The pattern continues with a semicolon, followed by something that equals something else. Overall, I match four things, and I store them all by enclosing them in backslash bracket pairs. The first two things I store are the two ntuples, while the other two correspond to the left and right-hand sides of the equal sign. Next comes the substitution part. This starts with the contents of the first tuple, that's backslash 1, followed by the contents of the left-hand side of the equal sign, that's backslash 3, followed by the contents of the second tuple, for backslash 2, followed by the right-hand side of the equal sign stored in backslash 4. If the substitution command succeeds, I use the T command to branch to the loop and repeat the substitution. At the end, I remove the trailing commas from the closed brackets by substituting any comma followed by a closed bracket with a closed bracket. I also add an equal sign between the two tuples. After completing the sed script, I set it to be an executable program. Now, running it on the file ntuples.txt, we get a tuple format of the variable assignments. We see that tuple a, b, c equals tuple 3, 5, 8, and tuple k, j equals the tuple 8, 9.
You might have heard the Towers of Hanoi story. According to this story, there is an Indian temple with three poles and 64 golden discs, one smaller than the other, placed on the first pole. The objective is to move all those discs, one by one, from the first pole to the third one. However, we are forbidden to ever place a bigger disc on top of a smaller one. As you might expect, this can be solved with a program. Astonishingly, George Bergman, a professor of mathematics at the University of California at Berkeley, has written a sed script that performs this task.
We will not go through this sed script in detail. Instead, let's have a quick look to understand its genuine complexity and what a sophisticated sed program can actually do. At the beginning, there is a substitution command, then some global commands follow, along with a few deletions, using the hold space to store information. Next, we see various other substitution commands and conditionals. Let's now see the script in action. I run sed, specifying with the -f argument to use the script file. As input, I enter colon abcd colon, which are the disks I am placing from the largest to the smallest one. I also include two empty colon-separated positions. The three positions correspond to the three poles. Throughout the script's execution, we observe the progressive movement of the disks. First, disk D moves to the third pole, then disk C moves to the second pole, then D moves on top of C, then B gets to the third pole, next D returns to the first pole, and so on. In the end, we have ABCD moved to the second pole.
This concludes our 2 units on processing data with SED. As always, stay with us.